Fish farming is a concept introduced by government in 2000 as a means to contribute towards food security in the country. Between 2000 and 2006, the Ministry of Trade and Industry put up 6 agriculture projects, mainly in the northern parts of the country. Despite a promising start to all these initiatives, 5 of them died due to flooding as they were built on unsuitable land, adverse climatic conditions, lack of maintenance and...
Yeah, unfortunately, the cooperative fish farms, there's only one that's still operating. Maybe two, Mpungu and I think it's Likunganyalo in the Caprini, yeah. But the rest, they didn't provide enough fish.
The situation is exacerbated by the depleting fish stocks in the fresh waters of the Kavango and Zambezi rivers, while the methods used to harvest fish in the fresh waters also affected the fish population. In an effort to re-establish the fish farming in the country, the Ministry of Fisheries and Marine Resources has established 6 inland aquaculture centers.
We are strategically placed now all over the country with research centers where we can provide the fish farmers with good quality fingerlings. So yes, I don't think we will build more research centers for fish farming. At the moment, I think we can produce enough fingerlings for all the farmers that are there.
They are at Onavivi, Omahenene, Ongwediva, Rundu, Katimamulilo and Inhardap region, and they all have 12 ponds in total. And Kluta is optimistic about the future of fish farming in the country.
The demand for the fish is there now, it's increasing. And if you look at the proposed or the estimated population growth, you know, especially in Africa, then we and Namibia are already well placed with providing fish to the rest of Africa, and we can just grow the aquaculture business, the freshwater fish also, yeah.
Jeff Tachomino, NBC News, Windhoek.